Hello friends, in this video we are going to discuss a numerical on non-uniform doping. So in this numerical it is given that there is a graph is given, that is a graph of Na versus position inside the semiconductor is given in the numerical, and Na means the acceptor concentration. Since it is an acceptor concentration, so we can say that the semiconductor is a p-type material. Now it has been asked to find the magnitude of the electric field in kilovolt per centimeter in the semiconductor due to doping. Now this is the doping concentration profile inside the semiconductor, and we can see that this doping concentration profile is not uniform throughout the position inside the semiconductor. So it is a non-uniform doping process. So we can say that this doping process is a non-uniform. Since it is a non-uniform doping process, so there must exist a built-in electric field inside the semiconductor, and we have to find that built-in electric field. So we know that in non-uniform doping process the current density will be constituted of two components. First one is due to the J drift, and second one is due to the diffusion component. Now at equilibrium condition, we know that this total current density J will be equals to 0. That is, the J total will be equals to 0, and this J total is nothing but the J drift plus J diffusion will be equals to 0. And we know the equation for J drift and J diffusion. It looks like Q mu P P and E. And for the J diffusion, since it is a p-type material, so the majority carriers here are holes, and for holes the diffusion current density is negative. So minus Q into dp into dp by dx, and this dp by dx is the concentration gradient of holes inside the semiconductor, and this total equation will be equals to 0. So from this equation we can write Q into mu P into P into E is equals to Q into dP and dP by dx. So from the both side we can cut out this Q. So we will get the value of the electric field like this. E can be written as dP, that is the diffusion coefficient for the holes, divided by mu P, mobility of the holes, and P into dP by dx. So, this P is nothing but the hole concentration inside this semiconductor, which will be equals to the acceptor concentration. So, and this P is not constant throughout the semiconductor. So, we can write that it is a function of position, that is x. So, the equation can be written dP by mu P into P of x into dP by dx. So, further we can write this equation like this. This dP by mu dP by mu P can be written as the thermal voltage of the semiconductor from Einstein equation. Now, if I replace this Vt in the place of dP by mu, the equation looks like built-in electric field capital E Vt divided by 1 by P of x into dP by dx. Now, this part can be written in this formation that this Px is nothing but the acceptor concentration with is a function of x. So, I can write this third bracket part as d by dx ln of Na of x. So, now this second bracket part can be written as d by dx ln Na into x, this third bracket. Now, the second bracket part can be written in this form that is ln 10 to the power 16 minus ln 10 to the power 14 2 minus 1 into 10 to the power 4. This data has been achieved from the graph. So, let us look at the graph. So, in the graph, we can see at position 1, the value of Na is 10 to the power 14. At position 2 micrometer, this graph of Na gives that it has a value of 10 to the power 16 atoms per centimeter cube. So, we have put the value of this Na at different position of x. So, if we know the Vt value at the room temperature, we know that it is 26 millivolt. So, we can write this equation as 0.026 volt divided by, in the numerator it will be 36, that is the ln of 10 to the power 16, that is 36, and 32.23, that is the ln of 10 to the power 14, and it will be 1 into 10 to the power minus 4. So, ultimately we can get the answer as 1198.6 volt per centimeter. So, this is the value of the built-in electric field inside the given semiconductor in this numerical. So, this is all about the given numerical. So, thank you.